Hello, my name is Shabani and I'm going to talk to you today about personality disorders, specifically Cluster B. Some of the learning objectives for this presentation include to understand the difference between personality trait and personality disorder, to learn to recognize personality disorders, to learn the characteristics and personality disorders specifically in Cluster B, and to understand the general treatment options for Cluster B. This is an outline. Again, some of the Cluster B characteristics include appearing dramatic, emotional, or erratic in their behavior. Cluster B disorders include the following types: histrionic, narcissistic, borderline, and antisocial. This is a categorical approach, however, an individual diagnosed with a personality disorder may have an additional personality disorder from a different cluster. Now I will discuss each type in more detail. Some of the key characteristics of antisocial personality disorder include a pervasive pattern of disregard for and violation of the rights of others, indicated typically by a few features, which include failure to conform to social norms with respect to lawful behaviors, as indicated by repeatedly performing acts that are grounds for arrest, deceitfulness, as indicated by repeated lying, use of aliases, or conning others for personal profit or pleasure. There is typically an impulsivity or failure to plan ahead, irritability and aggressiveness, as indicated by repeated physical fights or assaults, reckless disregard for safety of self or others is also a feature. There's consistent irresponsibility, as indicated by repeated failure to sustain consistent work behavior or honor financial obligations, lack of remorse, as indicated by being indifferent to, or rationalizing having hurt, mistreated, or stolen from another. The individual is at least 18 years of age, and there is evidence of conduct disorder with onset before the age of 15. The occurrence of antisocial behavior is not exclusively during the course of schizophrenia or a manic episode. In borderline personality disorder, there is a pervasive pattern of instability of interpersonal relationships, self-image, and effects, and marked impulsivity beginning by early adulthood and present in a variety of contexts, as indicated by a few of the following features. There's frantic efforts to avoid real or imagined abandonment, a pattern of unstable and intense interpersonal relationships characterized by alternating between extremes of idealization and devaluation. There can be an identity disturbance, markedly and persistently unstable self-image or sense of self, impulsivity in at least two areas that are potentially self-damaging, for example, spending, sex, substance abuse, reckless driving, or binge eating. There could be recurrent suicidal behavior, gestures, or threats, or self-mutilating behavior. There is affective instability and marked reactivity of mood. There can be chronic feelings of emptiness, and as well as inappropriate intense anger or difficulty controlling anger. There is transient stress-related paranoid ideation or severe dissociative symptoms as well. An individual with histrionic personality disorders typically have excessive emotionality and are attention-seeking. They typically are uncomfortable in situations where he or she is not the center of attention, Their interaction with others is often characterized by inappropriate, sexually seductive, or provocative behavior. There can be a display of rapidly shifting and shallow expression of emotion. This individual will consistently use physical appearance to draw attention to oneself. Their style of speech can be excessively impressionistic and lack in actual detail. They can show self-dramatization, theatrically, an exaggerated expression of emotion is suggestible of a histrionic personality disorder. They can be easily influenced by others or circumstances, and they often consider relationships to be more intimate than they actually are. Narcissistic personality disorder is typically described as grandiosity, a need for admiration, and a lack of empathy. A narcissistic individual can have a grandiose sense of self-importance. They can be preoccupied with fantasies of unlimited success, power, brilliance, beauty, or ideal love. They can believe that he or she is special and unique and can only be understood by or should associate with other special or high-status people or even institutions. They require excessive admiration. They have a sense of entitlement. They can be interpersonally exploitive. For example, they can take advantage of others to achieve his or her own ends. They often lack empathy and are unwilling to recognize or identify with the feelings and needs of others. They are often envious of others or believe that others are envious of them. They can show arrogance or haughty behavior and attitudes. So now let's talk about treatment. There's no specific medications that are approved by the Food and Drug Administration of the U.S. for the treatment of personality disorders. However, patients who present with personality difficulties not infrequently have other psychiatric disorders, including depression and substance abuse, that should be addressed with appropriate pharmacological treatment. Some studies suggest that it's more useful to target specific behavioral difficulties, for example, self-destructiveness, impulsivity, anger control, through psychodynamic therapy. SSRIs are often thought of as a first-line medical therapy for some personality disorders. Mood stabilizers may help stabilize the mood and reduce irritability or aggression. So in summary, a personality disorder arises when an individual's personality traits are so inflexible and maladaptive across a wide range of situations that they cause significant impairment and distress. Personality disorders are defined by specific DSM-IV criteria, and specific types of personality disorders are grouped in three clusters and defined separately. Cluster B characteristics are grouped into the appearing dramatic, emotional, or erratic group. Treatment can include both therapy and pharmacotherapy. Patients with personality disorder may benefit from early referral to a mental health professional. Patients with personality disorders are at increased risk for adverse outcomes related to physical trauma, suicide, substance abuse, and concurrent psychiatric disorders. Additionally, patients often have difficulty understanding their condition and establishing rapport with their clinician. Here are some key references from this presentation. Thank you.